lateral collateral ligament is a very important ligament in your knee. So just revising your ligaments. So the knee has four important ligaments. The ligament in the front is the anterior cruciate ligament. The ligament on the back is the posterior cruciate ligament. The ligament on the inside is the medial collateral ligament. And the ligament on the outside is the lateral collateral ligament. Now this lateral collateral ligament, along with two very other important structures, which are popliteus muscle and popliteofibular ligaments, makes the posterior-lateral complex, which is a very important structure to give the stability to the knee. Now let's talk about the LCL per se. Now LCL is a tubular cord-like structure which is about 2 to 3 millimeters thick and about 4 to 5 millimeters wide, and the total length is usually about 6 to 7 centimeters, and this gives a stability to knee against opening. So if you want to open it on the lateral side, it gives the stability. This is a very important structure when we talk about multi-ligamentous injuries, and it is very commonly torn in association with anterior cruciate ligament injuries. The cause of failure, if we talk about cause of failures of ACL reconstruction, this is the most important cause. Unaddressed LCL injuries are the most important cause for ACL ligaments which are not successful. Isolated injury to the LCL is very rare. It is more commonly in association with other injuries. Isolated LCL injuries is less than 2% of all the injuries, and approximately 7 to 16% is a combined injury, LCL with posterolateral complex, LCL with ACL, and vice versa. The most common mechanism is hit on the medial side. So if there is a hit like this, the knee will open like this and tear the lateral complex. You can have a varus stress injury, a external tibial rotation injuries, or a hyperextension kind of a injury, which can all lead to damage or injury to the LCL. Now if you talk about anatomy of the LCL, it arises from the femur or the thigh bone and goes up to fibula, that is a small bone on your leg. So that is why it is also called as a fibular collateral ligament. Now as I told you, the fibula it is attached on the anterior or in the front, whereas on the posterior part you have the popliteal fibular ligament and the biceps attachments. Now this gives the main restraint to the varus, so varus opening. So in 5 degrees to 50 degrees this is the most important structure which is helpful. Now this ligament is tight in extension and it becomes lax in flexion. It may also be associated with the common peroneal nerve injury because it is in close association. The common peroneal nerves goes on the neck of the fibula, which is very close to the LCL. So it is commonly associated with common peroneal nerve injury, which can lead to a foot drop kind of a situation. Also there is a dial test. So if your foot external rotation is more than 10 degrees as compared to normal side, then it is a positive dial test, and that means that your posterior lateral complex, that is a PLC injury, is there. That means LCL, the popliteofibular ligament, and popliteus are injured. If the dial test is positive in 30 degrees as well as 90 degrees, then both posterior lateral corner and PCL ligaments are injured. So if dial test is positive at 30 degrees, there is an injury to LCL, and if the dial test is positive at 90 degrees, you have an injury to both LCL as well as PCL and posterior lateral complex. Now as far as the grade of injury is concerned, you can see the grade with either a stress X-ray or an MRI scan. I personally do rely more on MRI scan to assess injuries in acute and chronic LCL. Now there are three grades of LCL: grade 1, grade 2, and grade 3. Grade 1 LCL have 0 to 5 mm of opening, grade 2 have 5 to 10 millimeters of opening, and grade 3 have more than 10 millimeters of opening. Grade 1 injuries, you have subcutaneous fluid surrounding the ligament. Grade 2 are partial injuries of the ligament, and grade 3 are complete tears. In grade 1 and some grade 2 injuries, we can treat the patient with immobilization in extension, whereas in all grade 3 and some grade 2, we need to do surgical intervention. Now, if you have a varus instability at 30 degrees, then a lateral collateral ligament is torn, whereas if you have a varus opening at 0 degrees as well as 30 degrees, you have a combined ACL with LCL injuries. Now, for severe injuries, we recommend surgical intervention. There are two kinds of surgeries that we can do. In acute scenarios, we can do LCL repair surgeries, specifically if the avulsion is bony or if the avulsion is from the fibular end. In chronic scenarios, we recommend doing a reconstruction surgeries. For repair surgeries, we recommend anchor repairs on the fibular head. They can be associated with some loosening, so you can add on internal brace to that. And for reconstruction surgeries, there are many techniques which are described. The most common are fibular based techniques, which is as described by Larson, in which we reconstruct the LCL and we may try to reconstruct the popliteal fibular ligament on the fibula. There are also techniques in which tibial side is concerned, so you can use a double, so fibula as well as tibia. So these are called as double fibula tibia based reconstruction, and these are posterior lateral complex reconstructions. And then you have a laparotomy technique which is based on two grafts which restores all the three components of LCL, the popliteal fibular ligament and popliteus, and these are usually required only in a very high or a very severe significant sort of a lateral collateral ligament and posterior lateral complex injuries. So friends, I hope that I am able to cover about the lateral collateral ligament injuries in detail. If you have any queries, you can write us on the comment box and you can contact us on the WhatsApp number given above. Please do subscribe to our channel, Advanced Hospitals. Thanks a lot.